Hello viewers, here's another video. It's about something I heard on the radio about five-year-old girls having sleepovers with their divorced dad. And why it's not good. Yeah, I know that's really not very descriptive, but I will go into detail, I promise. Now, according to a psychologist, the for a five-year-old girl to have a sleepover with their divorced dad, It's apparently a bad thing because it upsets the bond the daughter has with her mother, which is complete nonsense. Okay? They're actually trying to make it a rule that, oh, you've got a five-year-old daughter, you cannot have a sleepover with your dad. No. That's just stupid, right? Yes, I can understand it hurts the bond with the mother, but it should also increase the bond with the father. Okay? Now, I don't know. I can't understand why they're making this rule. Because apparently it's, they've had people, it's on the radio, so they've had people phoning in, email, texting, whatever, some form of communication. Saying, oh, well, my mum and dad split up and my bond grew with my mum. Oh, well, someone else come in saying, oh, my mum and dad split up, saying my bond grew with my dad. I did not like my mum at all. It's nothing to do with the mother and daughter. It's nothing to do with the gender. It's their lifestyle. If, for example, the mum might be working all the time, so they're not at home anyway. The mum might be an alcoholic, drug addict, smoker, whatever. Mum might not be in a very good job, so she's really angry all the time, creating a negative environment for the child. Whereas the dad might be in a better lifestyle than the mum. The reason they parents divorce through emotional and some difficult times. They're just not connecting in the same way, right? They're just not connecting the lifestyles and stuff. So why should the daughter stick with the mum? Why? Because that's going into the whole girls together and the whole gender. And says, and the mum's going to say, oh, you've got to grow up to be a little princess on a pink castle and all that. Whereas if he, and for some reason, in my head, I reckon the mums are thinking that, oh, if you go with dad, you end up being a grease monkey and go to the pub a lot. No, that's not necessarily true. That is sexist, for a start. Okay? They're not actually stopping the kids seeing the dad, they're just not letting them sleep over. Which I don't see the point. Why? Because it's just a stupid, stupid, stupid scenario. I'm lucky because my parents are both together, they're both doing well. A few arguments here and there, but that's natural. So, why? And the other side of the coin is if they've got a son, a five-year-old son, does that mean that the son has to stick with the dad? Because it's all boys together and all that. Why? You're trying to create an issue out of something, kind of make a rule out of an issue that's not that is not in your power. It's not your world to decide who goes with the kid and what the kid does. It's the parents are split up, but you should think, instead of saying, oh, you can't do this, you've got to think for the child's welfare. The daughter, the child, has to see both parents, right? They may not like one, they may like the other. They might not like one because the other is saying that, oh, your dad's such a horrible, horrible person and you never want to see him again, etc. And if the kid believes that, then it's actually the parents' fault. Because you don't get bad students, you get bad teachers, etc. So that's the rant for today. I'd be interested in hearing your posts on the comments below or on my Facebook page, The Baker 7. Oh, yes. This psychiatrist turned out to be female. Maybe that's something to consider. Thank you for hearing my video. I'll be interested, like I said, I'll be interested in your comments, your views, etc. And I'd like to hear from you again. Or something like that. I don't know, I'm just waffling now. I'm just, shut up, James.